In these labyrinth lanes of downtown Srinagar, just a little away from Zena Kadal and Badshah's tomb, as the Jhelum flows almost without a ripple, a pair of hands is deftly at work in a workshop, which is more of an attic really. The last of eight generations of craftsmen, Rahmanju is perhaps more of an artist. As he sits in his workshop, shaping blocks of wood and turning them into instruments capable of emitting sublime notes of music.
यूं ही लकड़ी का एक टुकड़ा इधर से उठाएंगे वो क्या बेजान है उस वक्त जब हम उसको जान देंगे जबान देंगे फिर ये बजाएगा
He makes almost all instruments, rababs, sitars, but it is the santoor which is his speciality. It is a string instrument and a direct descendant of the Ved Veena, one of the oldest musical instruments to be found in India. As Rahmanju gazes at the Jhelum from his window, he remembers the time his little workshop hummed with activity, a time when musical swaris, baithaks, and Sufiana kalams were a part of everyday life.
हाँ हाँ होते थे बैठक लगती थी इधर वो बजाते हैं उधर बैठते हैं बुजुर्ग लोग सुनते हैं सूफियाना म्यूजिक
Then ill winds blew, changing everything forever. This centuries-old musical tradition was frowned upon and almost became taboo.
क्योंकि कुछ डिस्टर्बेंस भी हुई है इसलिए वो साज अब चलते नहीं है
Pandits who played and taught the santoor left the valley in terror, leaving behind a silence and a void.
बहुत आनंद से बैठते थे वो पंडित लोग जो जब पंडित लोग यहाँ से चले गए उनका शोक भी बैठ गया वो
By the time normalcy returned, tastes had changed, perhaps forever.
उनमें आजकल के जमाने में यही समझो यही डांस शांस वगैरह ऐसा ही फिल्मी गाने आए वो खूब खुश होते हैं
But it is a matter of quiet pride for Rahmanju that all famous exponents of this instrument play santoors which have been made by him, as they enthrall listeners at home and across the world.
जब कोई साज बजाता है ना, हमको मालूम पक होता है कि ये हमारा साज है। जब किसी और का साज होता है, वो तो मालूम पड़ जाए वो हमारा नहीं है।
For him, his work. has never been just merely a means of livelihood but
aise logon ko samajhna chahiye ye ibadat hi hai
so he continues to sit in his little corner single-handedly shaping blocks of wood into instruments capable of creating divine melody